Morning, children. Let us continue with the Mughal Empire. So, we have studied about the great Mughals. We also studied about who were Mughals. So, let us recapitulate who were our six great Mughals. Babur was the first emperor of the Mughal Empire. After Babur, Humayun came on the throne. Humayun was succeeded by Akbar. After Akbar, Jahangir was the next Mughal emperor. Jahangir was taken over by Shah Jahan, and the last great Mughal was Aurangzeb. Children, we have studied about Babur, Humayun and Akbar till now. Babur was the first Mughal emperor. We studied about Humayun. Humayun was the eldest son of Babur, and Akbar was the greatest ruler of the Mughal Empire and the greatest ruler of India. So today we will start with Jahangir. After Akbar, Jahangir came on the throne. His reign was from 1605 to 1627. Almost he ruled for 2 decades, that is 20 years. After Akbar's death, Prince Salim ascended the throne and he was known as Jahangir. Children, literal meaning of Jahangir is conqueror of the world. So he conquered the world and he continued with the policies of Akbar. Coming on to Jahangir's military campaigns. Now, Jahangir inherited a large empire. As he took over the throne after Akbar, Akbar already expanded his empire all over India. So, he inherited a large empire and he consolidated it further. He crushed the rebellions of his own son, Prince Khusro. He also strengthened his control over Awadh and Bengal. He defeated Rana Amar Singh of Mewar. Along with this, he also conquered Kangra and he also tried to expand Mughal influence in the Deccan. Sir Thomas Roe, the ambassador of the King of England, came to the Mughal court to get some trading rights and concessions. Jahangir gave him these trading rights and concessions. Coming on to Nur Jahan. Nur Jahan was the better half of Jahangir. That means she was the wife of King Jahangir. Jahangir owed much of his success to his wife Nur Jahan. Nur Jahan also advised him on important matters. When Jahangir fell ill, Nur Jahan managed the affairs of the empire very well. But after Jahangir's death, Nur Jahan also retired from the public life. This was all about Shah Jahan. This was all about Jahangir, Nur Jahan and Jahangir's military campaigns. So children, let us come back to the timeline once again. So we started with Babur. Babur was succeeded by Humayun. Humayun was taken over by Akbar and Akbar was succeeded by Jahangir. We have studied about Jahangir. After Jahangir, Shah Jahan ascended the throne. So let us study about Shah Jahan. After Jahangir's death, there was a war of succession which was broke out between all the sons of Jahangir. Prince Khurram succeeded Jahangir and he defeated all his brothers and came on the throne. Prince Khurram was known as Shah Jahan, and the meaning of Shahjahan is ruler of the world. So Shahjahan ruled from 1628 to 1657.
Children, now let's study more about Shahjahan. You can see the picture of Shahjahan. That was the golden age of Mughal Empire. Let's study more about Shahjahan, Shahab-ud-Din Muhammad Khurram. Let us study about Shahjahan's military campaigns. Shahjahan's reign witnessed many revolts. The Bundela Rajputs of Bundelkhand revolted against Shahjahan. Shahjahan crushed this revolt easily. Next, there was a revolt in the Deccan. Shahjahan invaded the Deccan and annexed Ahmednagar in 1633. Bijapur and Golconda signed a peace treaty with Shahjahan and agreed to pay an annual tribute. After consolidating his position in the Deccan, Shahjahan sent an army to Balkh and Badakhshan in Central Asia in order to add Timur's capital of Samarkand to his empire. This campaign, however, failed. He also failed to recover Kandahar from the ruler of Persia. European traders continued their trading activities and they established trading outposts in different parts of the empire. Of the empire.
Let us study about Shahjahan as a king. How good was Shahjahan as a king? Under him, architecture witnessed tremendous growth. He built the Taj Mahal. Children, have you seen Taj Mahal? How beautiful it is? Yes, it was built by Shahjahan. Taj Mahal was built in the memory of his wife, Mumtaz Mahal. And Taj Mahal is at Agra, right? He also built a new city called Shahjahanabad, which is Delhi. And he made his capital as Shahjahanabad. After Shahjahan, Aurangzeb ascended the throne. Aurangzeb's reign was from 1658 to 1707. And he was the last amongst the great Mughals. When Shahjahan fell ill, a war of succession broke out amongst his four sons, Dara Shikoh, Shah Shuja, Aurangzeb and Murad Bakhsh. Aurangzeb defeated them all. All the three were defeated by Aurangzeb. That is, Dara Shikoh, Shah Shuja and Murad Bakhsh were defeated by Aurangzeb. Shahjahan was also imprisoned. And Aurangzeb crowned himself.